We're making another video. Why not? It's go time. Go big to go home. Go big to go home. All right. Go big to go home. We need to really go big. So today, what did I do? I tried to go big. I'm trying to go really big. I've been working on a lot of graphics for Jesus. They call it Mimi graphics, picture with a caption, or you write, put some text on it. They it's like saying, like a selfie, like the, you know, they have a new name and they say, well, we invented this, putting text on captions on pictures. Wow, it's a meme. Okay, whatever. So I'm doing a whole lot of that, you know, just a tremendous amount. It's pretty interesting. And, you know, just graphics, and it doesn't really amount to that much. But in today's world, you're expected to be able to have, you know, something on Facebook or Instagram or wherever where you have graphics that say something, visual. So I've been doing a lot of that. And at the same time, focusing in on the biggest news story in history, which, of course, the media is not covering. We don't expect it to. Expect the media to cover. It's something that each one of us has to look into. And let's keep in mind that, liberation from self-delusion is not like some invention that somebody invents and then you can go buy at a store like a smartphone. You know, that somebody produces it and you go to the store and pay some money and you get it and now you have it. It's nothing like that. It's nothing like that. I think most people are looking at spiritual truth as a consumer, from a consumer standpoint, and which is a dreadful mistake. Dreadful mistake. That's like saying someone can breathe for you. Yeah, I'm gonna hire somebody to breathe for me. Or I'm gonna, you know, it's ridiculous. I'm gonna hire somebody to eat for me. Okay, I'm gonna hire someone to think for me. I mean, what has to change is our thinking. What has to change is our belief. Our belief. We can't go into a store and buy something and say, okay, now I have the product. It's not a product. It's a change in our thinking. Now, the clearest scope of consideration right now is indeed that this world, this universe, these bodies, etc., are basically spirit pretending to staging its own fake suicide, and this world, bodies, and the universe is the corpse of its suicide, the corpse that proves that spirit has died. Okay, this is what's really going on. It's all pretend. It's all fake. And looking at it this way, I'm able to recognize now motivations that I couldn't see before, and now it becomes very obvious. Why do people act the way they do? Because they're acting intentionally stupid. Why? So that they can pretend that they're not spirit, that this is the corpse of spirit. This is the corpse. If we act too interested and are too successful in insight, it's like we're blowing our cover. And this is something I've always been afraid of in my life, saying, hey, Jesus, don't blow my cover. Don't blow my cover. I'm really afraid of it. And now I see the world, everyone in the world is acting this way. They don't want their cover blown. So they'll play dumb. They'll play dumb. It's all, this is why. Sure, I'm going to do this or that. Oh, no, I didn't do it. Because the spirit is producing this play, so it seems as though spirit has died, and its death has left this corpse. Okay. And this corpse is nothing like spirit. You know, this corpse is obviously not eternal life at all. It's a decaying, rotting corpse that can't get it right, that can't understand. And so now I'm seeing the world through these lenses, like I put on a new set of, you know, sunglasses or something. I'm seeing everything through these lenses. And wow, what an education that is. It fits. The stuff that you think you'd never figure out, now you say, oh, now I understand why they're doing that. Of course. In their mind, they're playing a role of not being spirit, of being the corpse of spirit. And so, of course, they have to try to figure out spiritual truth, but I just can't figure it out. Or, you know, I say practice. They say, well, yeah, I just can't quite practice. Well, of course, if you're pretending to be the corpse of spirit, you're not going to be able to practice. You're going to be incompetent. All right. So whenever you start to be competent, there's anxiety arises, okay? Because you think, wait a minute, maybe guilt is starting to get suspicious about what's going on here, and you get real nervous. That's why the spiritual path is so full of fear and dread and nervousness, because you're thinking, oh my gosh, I hope I'm not blowing my cover with guilt here. Okay, now what is guilt? Guilt is the imagined corpse of God. Okay, spirit wanted to change the will of God. It could not. It's impossible. Instead of real recognizing and accepting that it's impossible, what spirit did was says, oh, I did kill God, and here's its corpse. Guilt is its corpse. And this guilt is like very toxic to me, and it's like I'm afraid it's going to kill me too. This guilt is going to kill me, actually. You know, it's like God taking revenge. After God has died, God left this corpse of guilt to attack us. Well, of course, we needed to imagine some evidence that we had succeeded. Because since we didn't succeed at all, we just had to make believe, imagine that there was this guilt. And we thought, we said, okay, that's all right now. We'll just have to find a way to get rid of the guilt. And so we have faked our own deaths, faked spiritual death, thinking that guilt will see, oh, spirit's dead, okay, I don't need to search anymore. It's finished. Because the goal of guilt, we think, is to kill spirit. And so if guilt believes that spirit has been killed, then guilt will say, okay, fine. And then we think that spirit will turn to us, the corpse of guilt, and say, oh, I love you so much because you're the evidence that I needed, that spirit actually died. So I'm going to treat this evidence with great love and care and make sure that it's, you know, and this is our relationship, the deluded relationship with God that most people have is really with this imaginary guilt. And of course we bow and we scrape and we, you know, grovel and we pray and all this, you know, we think this pleases guilt no end, you know, because guilt smiles and says, look, yeah, yeah. Everything we do, we try to reinforce the notion that spirit has died. What need does spirit have to pray for something, to beg? Is spirit a beggar? Spirit, the Son of God, has everything. How could spirit, Son of God, be a beggar, be begging, you know? Some of them are begging, groveling, saying, God, please help us, we're so bad, we're just these frail little stupid humans, we can't understand anything. We're doing this to try to convince guilt that indeed that this really is the corpse of spirit, and this pleases guilt no end, we imagine. But guilt is just entirely imaginary. We just made it up out of thin air. You know, there isn't any, not even a speck of reality to it whatsoever. So we're caught up in this drama that doesn't, we don't need to be caught up in at all. We're playing stupid. We're playing so stupid. And I look back at my life, I realize, what happened? When I came into this world, I didn't play very stupid at all. In fact, people got freaked out because I was blowing their cover. They said, hey, man, you can't do that. This is going to blow our cover. What are you thinking? I mean, we got to convince guilt that we died, the spirit died, and this is the corpse of spirits. You got to play dead. You're coming here in this world, you got to play dead. And I said, I don't know if I can do that, you know. I could see this and have, I can see this and this. I'm so aware of all this. And so I had to figure out, how do I dumb myself down? How do I play dead? So I've been playing dead my whole life, you know, as I finally figured out. Did it very clumsily. Most people are way better at it, but it was difficult for me. Very difficult to play dead. And so I see this whole effort is just been to try and fit in and make and don't rock the boat. Oh my gosh, I don't want to upset anybody. I might blow the cover here, and guilt might start getting suspicious and say, what is that guy? You know, he's able to do this and this and this and this, and say, huh, that sure seems like a lot like spirit. You know, maybe spirit isn't quite dead. Maybe spirit's alive in some way. You know, and the guilt says, huh, I better go after it and really destroy it. Maybe this is a trick, you know. So this is what's going on here. This world is completely insane. It's an insane asylum. Okay. No question about it. There isn't any guilt at all. We just made it up so we could pretend that we did, you know, change reality. It's just so we could pretend we changed reality. But then we had that problem. So wow, because if we killed God, well, we're the extension of God. So then guilt seems to be very dangerous to us too, and out to kill us too, being the symbol, being the proof, evidence that we did kill God. You know, so this means, wow, we're killable too. You know, so we say, holy cow, how can we make guilt? You know, it seems like guilt is trying to kill us. So let guilt believe that it's killed us, but fake it. You know, we have to fake it because we can't die actually. We're trying to fake it. This is the madness that we face in this world. And you see people playing dumb. I've always had a difficult time. Why? For me, it's just simple, obvious. And everybody's pretending like they can't have no idea what I'm talking about. And I say, this is ridiculous. You're not even trying. You're intentionally confusing yourself. And now I realize this whole ego thing of being confused is intentional. It's a pretense. It's trying to prove to guilt that indeed spirit did die. And here's the evidence. Here's these silly little humans wandering around on this silly, you know, piece of dirt in this silly space, and we're like really stupid. You know? Doing really stupid things, believing really stupid stuff, and this is what we think is our salvation, because guilt, we think that guilt believes that this means that spirit died, so it won't really go after spirit at all. It'll be satisfied and say, okay, I don't have to be searching. I'm convinced. And I can now just relax and basically not think about it any longer, right? All the while, spirit's, you know, still alive. It's a defense. That's why people don't like anyone coming here, like Jesus, who obviously knows that spirit, that God didn't die, and that this is all a pretense. And the ego says, whoa, you can't do that. You're blowing our cover. What are you doing? This is crazy. We'll all die. Guilt will find us out and destroy us all. This is literally the madness of this place. Plug that into your life. And when I plugged into my life, everything fits. It all fits. I don't know exactly what to do about it, but this is certainly a step in the right direction. It all fits. And it's frustrating because I see that people are intentionally playing dumb. I see it all the time. I do it myself. We all do it, right? I'm constantly afraid that someone might think I'm too smart, you know, and they say, oh, you can't have that. You're blowing our cover. You gotta pretend to just be flesh, body. Not knowing this, not knowing that, struggling with this, desperately trying to survive and all this stuff. Yeah, that's what, this is the marketing campaign that we're selling to guilt. But the guilt is all only in our mind. It's non-existent. Doesn't really exist at all. So this is changing my outlook, you know, surely, slowly but surely. You start to look at people in a different way, and you realize everybody's just playing a role, what they think is effective in convincing guilt that spirit really is dead, that you're just a, you know, the corpse of spirit. Now, it seems quite convincing. I mean, to believe that you're this body, that spirit is now this body. It's all that's left of spirit is this body. You know, that literally would seem like a corpse. This is a corpse. So we're thinking we're this body. It means that we're this corpse, and the idea, well, the corpse does all this stuff. Well, I mean, so does a corpse. So the body dies. What does it do? It rots, ferments. All sorts of breaking down happens in the body, right? Well, that's really not any different than the stuff that the body does in relation to spirit. I mean, the body, you know, eats, gets up in the morning, walks, goes to the car, drives somewhere, you know, works a while, eats some more lunch, goes to the bathroom, you know, goes home, eats some more, goes to sleep, gets up and, you know, drinks something, and talks and walks, and, you know, I mean, compared to spirit, this is like a, you know, a corpse just decomposing. I mean, the world really, you look at it, it just seems like everything's just decomposing corpse in terms of functionality. You could say that compared to spirit, the functionality we're producing is no more functional than a rotting corpse of a body just lying on the street, rotting. It's about the same level of functionality. We just seem to be, non-functional, falling apart, collapsing. And so we think, wow, this must be really, really convincing to guilt. The situation that we've come up with here, my gosh, it's convincing. I mean, we're almost convinced that we're dead. That's how clever our creativity is. But then occasionally some people come by, like Jesus says, hey, folks, you're not really dead here. I'll show you a few things, and yeah, you can do all that stuff too. You're just pretending. And we say, wow, hey, maybe we're not dead. Sure seems like it. It does, doesn't it? Doesn't it seem like, in some ways, that we're all dead? We're just the walking dead? Like we're all zombies, just the walking dead. I mean, guilt looking at this could never even imagine that spirit wasn't dead. It would say, oh, of course, this doesn't correlate with spirit in the slightest bit. And we even say, yeah, I used to be spirit, but now spirit's died, and this is what's left. Just the husk, the outer, just a frail husk is all that's left now. These ridiculous bodies and worlds. So looking at it this way, you begin to recognize people and forgive them more. You're seeing what's going on. They're playing a desperate game of pretense. Now, I've had troubles with those who pretend to be stupid, and I'm so frustrated. I think I got to teach them. How can they be taught? How can they be that dumb? It's so frustrating. Now I see why. They're desperate. That they think guilt might have found them out. And in fact, what I've noticed also is if you teach spiritual truth to some people, they go in the opposite direction. They become even stupider because they're terrified. Oh my gosh, if I let on that I understand this stuff, guilt's going to know that I'm not dead. And then it's going to come after and attack me. So I really got to play dumb here. And so they ask questions that appear to be like coming from, stupidity. Pretending to be really stupid. And you hear that and say, what? What are you talking about? Why are you asking this question? That's completely ridiculous. But for them, it's not. They're trying to prove that just a corpse of spirit. That spirit died and left this ridiculous corpse. And obviously this isn't spirit because this ridiculous corpse is asking ridiculous questions, showing it doesn't have any reasoning capacity at all. What's Trump up to? I don't know. That's small potatoes compared to this. Very small potatoes. We're finding out the key to the entire situation. The key that cures everything. The key that cures everything. Because all suffering is merely spirit pretending to be dead. It's pretending to have committed suicide. Everything. You get sick, you get cancer. I mean, what a great way to show guilt that, hey, I'm not spirit. I'm just this body. And look at this body. It's succumbing to death. Look at this body. Oh yes, I'm injured. I've got cancer, I've got this, and obviously, I mean, spirit, how can I be spirit? I can't be. It's impossible. Spirit can't be sick. Spirit can't have problems, can't have injuries, can't die, can't any of this. But this body, which, you know, certainly can, and we're certainly doing it, you know. So obviously, spirit, if we were spirit, we wouldn't be doing this. This is what we're saying to guilt. Look at this guilt. Non-existent guilt, actually. I got cancer. I got sickness. In a way, it's an interesting catch-22, because this is the situation, and we have to find out that it is the situation. But in doing so, we can get scared and say, uh-oh, you know, I think I just, you know, broke my cover a little bit. Like, we're all undercover spies, and we think, uh-oh, wow, I better get sick. I better get sick, because I think I just broke my cover. I get really sick here. So when I finally got convinced, you know, that, yeah, there really was guilt, we have to convince it and stuff, then I got really sick, because I said, oh my gosh, I've been talking truth to the world and blowing my cover and blowing everyone else's cover, but I got to really overcompensate now and get really sick and tired and all this stuff. And so when guilt comes looking, you know, sniffing around like a dog, bloodhound, you know, hey, I mean, what's this? Oh, look at that poor wretch, you know. Oh, wow, spirit can't have anything to do with this. It's not possible. This is just the carcass of the husk, a dead husk of spirit. And I've been doing that ever since, you know, shaking in fear, like, oh my gosh, what happens if guilt finds out, you know, that I'm not really, you know, the corpse of spirit, that I'm really still spirit. Oh my gosh, that's terrible, I gotta keep... So, this is what drives us. So, to counteract this, we have to full stop in the wow, which is so important. You don't go into sickness, you don't go into panic mode. We know this is all complete make-believe that we're engaged in, utter make-believe. But it's powerful enough, our fear is powerful enough for us to imagine all sorts of infirmities and limitations and diminishments of the body and the mind, and to suffer horribly as a way to try and convince ourselves that guilt is convinced, that, you know, we've already paid the price, so guilt can just go away. It's, you know, go away, I'm a debtor no more, that kind of thing. So, but when we full stop in the wow, it prevents this from happening. But I've found that we love our infirmities and our frailties, and we cling to them. It gives us a sense of relief. And I look back, you know, in my earlier years when I wasn't doing this, and I think, oh my gosh, how crazy I was, how reckless I was, now how much safer I am now. I don't know what I was doing. I was courting disaster. What an idiot to court disaster like that. Holy cow. Reckless. So reckless in my youth. Not taking into account the horrible vindictiveness of guilt. You know, well, what a folly. And so now I'm thinking, oh, I'm so much safer, I'm so sick and so firm, getting older, got guilt looks at me and says, oh yeah, okay. Yeah, that's a real good example, that for sure, and spirit's dead here, no question about it. And this is how we end up looking, we end up valuing our troubles. And I used to think that people wanted to part with their troubles, now I find out that's the last thing they want to part with. They just want to... The reason why people want to be happy in this world is to say that they're happy with this, with their frailty and this corpse. They're happy as bodies, and they want to convince guilt that they're not looking for anything else, right? Because guilt is looking to see Is there any evidence that these bodies are searching for spirit in a tense way? And so we're desperate to convince guilt. No, 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 no. We just kind of have this superficial thing. We go to church and blah, blah, blah. Okay. And they come home and let's have barbecue. Let's have drinks. Let's, you know, watch the movie and spirit. And then guilt says, oh yeah, okay. They're not really interested in, yeah, spirit would be really interested in spirit, but obviously, you know, they're not. Spirit must be dead. So we're you know, fixated on these roles of diminishment, severe diminishment, trying to convince what we think is guilt, what isn't really a guilt at all. Because we could not change God, so there's no corpse of God. We didn't do anything to God. There's no guilt corpse demanding our death at all. And so gradually we let this, you know, this sink in, and gradually we just start to, you know, get this perspective. Now, I had many, many dreams, a whole constellation. I can't explain. There were so many that indicated I was coming aware of all sorts of defenses in the world and how it really is. And it was like really amazing. Really amazing. I said, oh, so that's why they're doing that. And this is why you're doing that. I'm starting to see now why people act so oddly in this world. They act like they're going to do something really big, and then, you know, they don't do anything. And you say, what happened? Well, of course, they're just showing guilt, trying to show guilt. Look, guilt. You know, even when I'm just showing you that, even when I try to connect with spirit, I can't. There is no connection. You know, so there's just like ancient memories that are still bubbling around me. When these ancient memories bubble up about, you know, maybe impressions of maybe I used to be alive, but I tried to do something and it just, nothing happens. You know, it's a failure. So we do this to ourselves, actually. Trying to stay on the good side of guilt. That's why people worship guilt as God. And they say, God, look at what a terrible sinner I am. What a miserable person I am. How helpless I am. How hopeless I am. And incompetent. And do all these wicked things. And I'm so terrible, God. You know, I mean, I can't help myself. You know, I'm just this awful, sinful, you know, dying body. You know, that's all I am, God. And so I just hope that you, you know, maybe walk through my house a little bit and, you know, take away some of the troubles and illnesses. I got so many illnesses, God. Wow, it's just horrible. All of this stuff is just, we're just hoping that guilt is seeing this. Hey, guilt, you know, we're like, yeah, we're putting on this show for guilt. Saying like, wow, guilt, look at how helpless I am. I have to And of course, we're really praying to guilt, so guilt hears this. And guilt looks at it and says, ah, good, 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 yeah, yeah. This is what we think, that we're playing these two sides of this, of the situation. We're playing both sides of the situation. We're playing the role of the guilt, and then the one playing the role of the one who is spirit, the corpse of spirit. We're playing both those roles in our mind. Very amazing stuff, huh? How are we doing here? Wow, we have not gone along so long already. It seems like it's been a long time. Well, maybe the intensity of what we've covered is so much that... Because this really is, you know, the whole bowl of cherries here. I mean, we've completely turned our perspective around. Completely flipped the script. And that's why now so many questions are being answered. You know, why don't people, they say, help, 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 and they try to help them and say, no, 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 I don't, you know, I don't really want that much help. And they want to show that they're really not getting helped. Because if they started being held, maybe we think, hey, guilt might be suspicious. Like, what's helping them? Maybe spirit is just pretending to be dead. You know, that's why spirit is like coming back to life, so to speak, dropping the pretense. And so guilt is looking very carefully, we think. And so we see some illness, and we got to be very careful, you know. What do we do about it? You know, what kind of situation we're in? What do we do? Make sure that it doesn't work. Or we get better, but then we relapse. You know, we get better, relapse, then we die. And guilt says, oh, okay, yeah. Spirit must be dead, because otherwise spirit certainly would have saved them, you know, and saved itself there. It wouldn't have gone through this nonsense. So this is the most fortuitous perspective. Just you cannot even describe it. My dreams are indescribable in terms of the intensity of clarity and clarification and realization of the dreams. It was like all around, just everything. So I just said, wow, how do I sort all that out? I really can't. You just let it be. There's so many insights happening now that, you know, everything I say almost is like a new insight that I never thought about before. You know, I just plug this new theory in. And see how it fits. You know, seek but don't find is a motto here. The seeking indicates that we at one time we were spirit, and then the not finding indicates that indeed spirit is now dead. So it cannot find. It's incapable. And we think this really convinces guilt. Oh yeah, guilt, we've really died. And of course, the guilt doesn't exist. The guilt doesn't exist. Made it up entirely out of our imagination. Stayed up late last night till, I think, 2 o'clock in the morning, so I'm a little tired now, working on all those graphics. It's hard to stop. I really did a lot of very cool stuff. But how do you capture, you know, you cannot capture this perspective. I mean, you just have to hear it and let it sink in. Just, wow, we're intentional fumblers and bumblers. And you try to help out, and people say, hey, what are you doing? Get away from me, get away from me. You're blowing my cover. And this is what I see. No one wants to have their cover blown. I go around everywhere. I say, hey, folks, I know the truth. And is anyone interested? Nobody's interested. That's the last thing they want. They say, what do you mean? Get away, get away. Guilt might think that I'm talking to you, and they might think, hey, maybe I'm spirit. Or why am I talking? Maybe I'm entertaining these ideas you're talking about. And guilt will say, wait a minute. That's not what a corpse of spirit would be doing. Corpse of spirit would just be, you know, stuffing their face with pizza or something. I mean, so people are scared. Stay away. You know. Don't blow my cover. So really, it's extraordinary how, you know, this has not been understood throughout history. And it's simply because people don't want to blow their cover. They'll turn some other direction and studying there, going this direction and you know, barking up the wrong tree. And they think, oh, that's great that guilt is seeing that I'm barking up the wrong tree. And of course, spirit wouldn't do that. So we act really stupid here. I've always thought this world is, why is it so stupid? Why is everybody so stupid? They're not really stupid. It's spirit pretending to be stupid. No one's really stupid. It's all a pretense. So I'm just letting this sink in, full stop on the wow. I'm not struggling with it too much. It's kind of like a flower that's blooming. Let it bloom. I don't know where it's taking me, but I'm not too concerned about that. Yeah, what a weird little place. It's like, I say, hey God, you know, I'm here to help you out and help people understand the truth, but nobody's interested. What the heck's going on here? And when they do seem to be interested, they're not really interested. They're pretending to be, but off topic, you know, off topic, away from the narrow gate, so to speak. They're going over there, or tangent, this way, that way, that way. It's all tangential, which is what you'd expect from the corpse of spirit, that it wouldn't know where to go, wouldn't know where to look, wouldn't be able to focus in on what's important. So we all have our ideas of how to pretend to be dead. And that's all that anyone is doing here, is pretending to be dead. Yeah, I always say, what am I doing? What am I doing? Am I talking to a dead person here? What, you know? Well, you know, I'm talking to those who are pretending to be dead. Of course, everyone here is pretending to be dead. Almost everyone. There's some nervous reactions here that are trying to come up because, you know, this just isn't talked about, because you'd say, well, you're blowing my cover. I'm blowing my cover. Wow, can't do that. But, of course, keep in mind, there isn't any guilt. There's nothing out for retribution. Nothing out to attack us. There's nothing trying to destroy us. We're still completely invulnerable because we didn't harm God. We didn't do anything to God. In a sense, we are the extension. We're one with God. We are God. All is God. The will of God is all. That means we're still perfect. We're completely invulnerable. Nothing happened to us. Now, politics is just this wonderful diversion, which though pretending to be dead. Why else would we be interested, really? So all this interest we're giving to various things, it reinforces in our minds. We're being really putting on a very good act of being dead here. So Jesus is back, but nobody wants to relate, because why? They say, hey, Jesus, you're going to blow my cover. I mean, guilt's going to say, hey, wait a minute, you're associating with Jesus? Wow, you must be spirit. You must not be dead. So now I'm going to go after you and really annihilate you. So we say to Jesus, stay away, stay away. Don't get too close. And we pretend to be real stupid and, you know, in relation to Jesus, and can't figure out what Jesus is saying, and distort it and twist it, which is just another way we pretend to be spirit. Like, we hear the truth and then we say, oh, we hear yes and we say, oh, they said no. The opposite. Well, what else would do that but a corpse, you know? Get that wrong. If the answer is yes, and then we insist that we heard it saying no, you know, that's pretty strong evidence, right, that we're dead to what we once were. Dead to what we once were. We're like a corpse to what we once were. Can't even get the simple yes, no, right. You know, when we hear yes on something is yes, fact, then we hear no, it's not a fact. And so this is really powerful evidence, we think, that shows that we're dead, spirit's dead. So what we're trying to do is blow our cover here, intentionally blow our cover. Yeah, this is what I've been trying to do. But you gotta be careful, because people are so scared that of guilt that their cover will be blown, that they get frantic if it seems like their cover is being blown. They feel they'll be going to be annihilated, that guilt will say, aha, gotcha. You are just faking. Nah, I'm really not going to be deceived any longer. I'm going to get you, and I'm going to annihilate you. And spirit says, too late, guilt, I'm already dead. I'm already dead. See, here's the evidence. I'm this run-down alcoholic, stupid, you know, you could, whatever it is. Well, I'm wealthy, but I'm alcoholic, and I'm just hanging around, getting fat, stupid, lazy, no motivation, obviously dead to what I once was, entirely dead. Just some faint echoes, you know, as the corpse gradually decomposes. So when you see people behaving in bizarre ways, that's their way of trying to convince guilt that they're dead. They're dead to what they used to be, which is spirit, perfection. And they say, look at me, look how terrible, I'm behaving like an absolute barbarian, it's crazy. I mean, you know, spirit would never act this way. I must be dead to what I used to be. There's no question about it. It's obvious. Sometimes the more you try to help people, the more they rebel and get worse. So, you know, you try to take an illness away from them and they'll make it worse. So maybe you should just say, hey, by all means, hang on to whatever you're doing, pretensions. Don't try to get rid of it. Hang on to it. We're not trying to have you get rid of it at all. We're just practicing this full stop in the wow. Even the wealthy people are letting their lines die now. Absolutely. The big corporations, the banks, went past a bank today, and they had all this beautiful landscaping and lawn, banks of lawn around it. It's all completely brown, dead as a doornail. I said, that looks nice. You know, the yellow straw-like color is the new green here, California. Just, you know, we're used to it now, brown and yellow, the tones of dry vegetation it's the new green here. And so it didn't look bad, it looked nice. Yeah, we're saying, look at this world. Guilt, spirit had to have died. You know, this has no. This is like a corpse. This is died to what spirit used to be. Obviously, look at this. We have droughts. We have famines. We have floods. We have changing weather of all types, and we have, you know, wars and everything. Of course, this is spirit's died to what it is, and this is just a leftover corpse. What other explanation is there? Guilt? It must be that. And guilt says, yeah. At least we imagine guilt says this. Yeah, I mean, look at this. These wretched people. You know, struggle to get a living and get cholera and die of diarrhea and, you know, and get just all these hideous illnesses and plagues and sicknesses and infirmities. And I says, of course, it's spirit couldn't possibly be doing this. There's no way. No way spirit would do this, would fake this. This must be true. Spirit must have died. But this is really just a measure of how frightened spirit is and to what lengths it takes its creativity to put up this fantastic charade. It's a fantastic charade is all it is. Very artfully conceived. But in the bottom of our mind, we know it's all fake, and since we know it's all fake, we were afraid that we might let that slip and guilt might find that out. You know, so we never feel secure, actually. No matter what we do, we still don't feel secure. Even when we die, you know, now we're dead. That really proves that we're not spirit. The body died. And then, but still thinking, you know, maybe, you know, we know this is all fake. Maybe guilt might figure that out someday, you know. Wow, I better identify with another body just to show that death was, not one death wasn't good enough. I got to die again. See, reincarnation, just say, hey, that first death might not have convinced guilt. Let me give another one. Make sure it's even a more convincing one. And then that one died. You say, well, that was pretty convincing. But, you know, I still feel like that. I know it's all I'm just make-believe. And what happens if guilt might find that out? So I better make-believe a more convincing death. So I better do it again. It's like that. That's why we're reincarnating and producing all these cover stories for it. All these ridiculous cover stories that we know are not true, but we believe in them so much. You know, say, wow, this should be convincing. Let's all believe in it. Let's all act like complete knuckleheads here, you know, and just not look for the answer, but don't find it at all. And that should be convincing. So, see, it gives a completely different take on what we call human behavior, what it really is. So, this is what the Holy Spirit helps us see, right? Jesus is an example the Holy Spirit uses, saying, look, Jesus saw this too. So, you certainly can as well. All of us can. So just take this information as a matter of fact, and let the wow of it be there. Don't struggle. Just say, okay, this is very, very helpful, but I'm not going to try and force anything. Just keep on considering this. And this is just a huge wow, isn't it? Totally different explanation for everything that's going on here. Completely different. That really almost no one's ever heard. Almost. Rarely is anything this type of a little spider is going through here. Okay, it's going up to there. Let it go. Climbing. It's the ultimate climbers. I don't know how they do it. It's pretty amazing. Very industrious. But there again, a world full of organisms desperately struggling to survive. What utter nonsense. Spirit would never do, never could never be involved in anything like that. This is, and we think, proudly we think, ah, see, this is the great, deception of guilt. Guilt will never be able to see through this deception. Got an entire world here full of all these organisms. And, you know, it's got nothing to do with the spirit at all. You never would connect the two, connect the dots. Guilt can't possibly connect the dots. It's ridiculous. But again, this is a testimony to our, you know, the creativity that we have. Looks like the spider's trying to spin a little web. And we've made up, guilt's completely made up. We made up that when guilt, you know, gets our death, then it will be satisfied. Its thirst will be quenched forever. This is what we're hoping. That we find a way to quench the thirst of guilt forever. So it no longer has any interest in revenge. And of course, this whole notion that we're putting up, like, that we're going to be good little people, good little humans living here in this world forever, utopia here in this world, that's all part of trying to deceive guilt. Absolutely it is. Of course, we don't have the slightest desire to continue on with this stupid dream, continue to pretend to be bodies in the world of all these organisms and stuff. That's the last thing we want. That has nothing to do. We have no value in it. We see no value in that whatsoever, spirit. But we're afraid that that might get out. So instead of that, we're saying, no, we got to make a utopia out of this world. Of course we're bodies. We want to try to extend the body's life as long as possible. And we're going to be real happy here. We're going to figure out how to be real happy here. And so this is, again, just trying to convince guilt that, you know, that spirit is dead. Because these are ridiculous goals. You know, spirit would never have such ludicrous goals as that. It's to try and remain a body. Yeah, the body's great. This is wonderful. This is our life now. Let's see how happy we can make the body. So, all this stuff we're hearing in the world are just defenses. It's just defenses. Trying to deceive guilt. Saying how, oh yes, come back Jesus and turn this world into a utopia. You'll be the ruler of this world and we'll be so happy to stay here and serve under you, knowing that this is the true kingdom of God right here, this planet, this world with all these organisms and dust and decay and everything. Oh yeah, this is exactly what we want. What is this spider doing now? This is all just, again, self-deception, trying to deceive guilt, which is ultimately self-deception. Because guilt doesn't exist. Pretty heavy stuff, huh? But that's where we're at now. It's the apocalypse. We're lifting the veil on everything and enjoying it. Zero times anything is still zero. Keep that in mind. Lies times anything is still lies, right? This tiny little spider is so small, and it's moving, the breeze hits it and it just like moves this way, it moves that way, moves that way, but it's got some little, you know, line going up there, a little rope. Now it's climbing again. I don't know what it's doing. It goes down and it climbs back up again. It's hard to say what his game is. Hit it. Okay, now it's. But very purposeful. I mean, spiders, they're really. I mean, they're thinking. They're thinking, aren't they? Or at least it seems that way. And we pretend we're thinking here. We're thinking all the time. We're trying to figure stuff out. Thinking is another way. We're trying to trick guilt. I mean, spirit doesn't need to think about anything. So we're constantly thinking. Ah, I'm thinking. I can't figure this out. I'm thinking. Well, what better way to convince guilt that spirit has died? And this has no correlation to how spirit really is. It also must be the death of spirit. Spirit must have died in order for these bodies to be thinking. Trying to think. I need to think. Spirit doesn't need to think. It knows. It knows whatever it needs to know, it knows. And yet we're doing all this thinking. That's part of the pretending to be dead. The struggling. The stress. All pretending to be dead. Spirit pretending that it's dead. So yeah, I don't know what the result of this is going to be. I'm in terra incognita right now. That's for sure. But I just, you know, just hang out and be relaxed as possible. Don't struggle. Just full stop in the wow of it. Just say, wow, this is really tremendous. Okay. But just wow. I'll just stay with the wow. I'm not going to even label it, you know. Just stay with the wow. Neutral. Sort of saying, well, I might be dead and I might not be dead. I'm not saying either way. Sort of like play it that way, you know. Play it that way. I might be dead or I might not be dead. Don't commit to either one. As you gradually burn off, you know, the fear that is lingering, because we've been using this fear for so long, but you know, it lingers, and we're used to continuity of this fear. We're kind of used to it, so we have a continuity issue and of letting it go. So just say, well, I'm not saying I'm alive and I'm not saying I'm dead. I'm not saying either one. And then just let the wow, you know, gradually subside. I'm tired. Lack of sleep last night. Couldn't stop. That's how it is when you're in a creative jag. You know, you don't want to stop. You just want to go. Because if you're in a groove, it's all working for you. And then you can put out tremendous output. And then you kind of hit a slump and you're not so inspired. You don't have the push. And then this is how it goes. Some artists can push it a lot. Those are the exceptions. So you might like to say to somebody, yeah, you know, this existence is just spirit pretending to be dead, pretending that it committed suicide, pretending to be dead, to trick guilt. But the guilt doesn't exist because we didn't change reality. And someone will say, you know, do you know what time it is? Oh, yeah, by the way. Oh, yeah, by the way, what time is it? Oh, yeah, or, last year something like, you know, this might be off the topic, but where did you get that, you know, where did you get those shoes or something? Yeah, so just, you know, they'll just completely pretend that they didn't even hear what you said or don't understand or are not interested. Now, it doesn't mean that they're not interested or didn't hear it. It just means that if their fear of the guilt, you know, having their cover blown, they've got to, like, act like, oh, I didn't hear it. Don't know what you're talking about. Not interested. Not interested at all. And so this information will get more and more used to it, more and more obvious, and we'll see how it goes. I'm not going to try to figure it out. Just whatever, you know, whatever happens, happens. Just keep working at it. Just stay in the wow of it. Stay in the wow. So hey, we hit 1 hour. That's pretty good. So this is is about as intense as we can get at this time, right? Because this is just a complete paradigm shift. Absolute, total, complete paradigm shift. And it's not easy for anyone to do that, to look at it, because they say, wow, this is really blowing my cover. I don't know if I want to blow my cover yet. I'm not really sure that's a good idea. But as I say, go big to go home. In order to go home, you got to go big. I mean, you got to do everything you can to blow your cover every day. You got to keep pushing it. And this is the key. Just blow your cover, blow your cover. You know, just do everything you can to blow your cover. Those are the ones, of course, that will be saved. And the others will keep pretending that they can't be saved. Oh, I succumbed, I failed. Well, obviously, I'm not spirit. I'm spirit died and left this corpse here. And still, they'll keep pretending, you know, keep trying to fool guilt. What a horrible situation, right? To be governed by fear and then trying to fool guilt that you're dead. I mean, this is the situation we're in. Situation, quote unquote, because we can easily just realize this all nonsense. There isn't any guilt, so we don't need to believe we're in any such situation at all. And so the reason why the mind will go zigzag off, because it's like saying, it's you know, pretending like, oh, I'm not really interested in that stuff, or I don't really understand it, oh, you know, or I'm not really focused on it or anything. In other words, oh, I'm not spirit. I'm spirit died a long time ago. I mean, I'm just the corpse of spirit. I'm just sort of the leftover of the constant effect of the spirit's death. You know, but I'm not spirit at all. You know, this is what we're trying to portray in our lives, in our interactions. The whole world's this way. Some people, you know, you could say that you can't relate with anybody straight here at all in the world. That's an accurate statement, because they're terrified. You know, can't pull my cover. Some of us put on some very clever, sophisticated covers, to say the least. But it's all very sophisticated. This whole situation is sort of pretending to be dead is quite a difficult endeavor. Spirit pretending to be dead, to no longer be spirit, is extraordinarily complex and difficult and entangled and confusing, and, you know, just, it's so difficult. The spirit always believes it's going to slip up. You know, might slip up some moment. Might do something that people say, hey, how'd you do that? You know what? Of course, this used to happen to me constantly, which I got really nervous after I realized I'm supposed to pretend that I'm dead. I got really anxious and frightened because I said, I'm not sure how I can keep all this stuff from happening. I used to know what's going to happen ahead before it happened all the time. That was my normal way of functioning. I knew exactly what was going to happen before it happened. I said, holy cow, I can't function like that. People will think I'm still spirit. I used to know what people were going to say. And it just, you know, just aware of the flow, what the flow is. And this is what's, you know, here comes the flow. I know it. And I said, I got to stop that. This is terrible. Not only blow my cover, blow everybody's cover. That's what the world told me. I'm going to blow everybody's cover. So, you know, you can't do that. You'll be the worst person ever. Well, you'll end up causing everyone to be annihilated, which is, again, you know, completely insane, because there isn't any guilt. God cannot be annihilated or anything. We are the extension of God. We're God the Son, and that is God as an extension. So we can't be annihilated. It's ridiculous. But people act as if we can. So I really had tried to play dumb, but it was severely difficult for me, and still is. You just can't say you meet somebody and just you say, "Oh yeah, how are you?" And act like you know them, because I saw you in a dream two nights ago. I dreamed about the whole situation. You know, we're gonna have this interaction that goes just like this and this and this, and there's just this little time lapse here to make it seem like we're dead, you know. And they're gonna look at you like, "Hey, you're blowing our cover." You know, you can't say that. You couldn't have dreamed about me 2 days ahead of time. It's impossible. This is just happening now. We're dead. Your own spirit would have known ahead of time, but we can't. And this is the trouble I have. Like, you know, I have to. How do I act around people if I already know what the whole situation is? You know, you have to pretend like you're all awkward and don't know how to act like that. We're all nervous, you know, around one another. We don't want to blow the cover, you know. But I used to dream about events about one to 2 days ahead of time, usually about a couple days. Every single night. And I wake up. I slept very lightly. I wake, get up, and then I'd go over the dream to say, "Okay, I know what's going to happen in a couple of days," and then it would happen exactly the way I dreamed it. And just this went on for, you know, just like a decade or so, long time. And before that, I you know, was aware, more consciously aware of what's going to happen. And because we are the flow. We are the flow. And this was very nerve-wracking, because I reacted to the world. I'd say, "Hey, wait a minute. This is what I dreamed of 2 nights ago. Okay, now in the dream, what happened?" You know, I think, okay, this is what happened in the dream. And then I said, okay, so I'm already prepared for this happening. So now I can choose something different, you know, like that. I don't have to go along with this. So, you know, but people are like, you know, feel like, "Wait, I'm not sure, you know, what's going on here. It's different than I'm used to. And maybe our cover is being blown." Don't blow our cover. Don't blow. Come on. We have this tacit agreement, everyone. I won't blow your cover. You don't blow mine. Right? So I'm okay. You're okay. I'm dead and you're dead. And that's okay. We're both dead, right? Oh yeah, sure. Okay. Shh, don't tell anybody. We're not. Yeah, I had this dream last night and I had this, you know, vision of this, and I said, shh, don't say anything. Don't say anything. Just talk about politics. Talk about politics and sports and the weather. You know, just maybe a little bit of sprinkle, a little bit of silly religion in there, and you know, and guilt will say, "Oh yeah, good little dead zombies there. That's fine. There must can't be spirit there. Nothing to see here. Time to move on." It's like we're undercover spies or something, and the government is looking for us. You know, trying to find where are those spies. We know they're somewhere, and you know, they see the search party passes by, and we're just busy, you know, doing what we do, working, pretending, but inside we're like shaking, oh my gosh, maybe they're onto me, you know. And they finally pass by, and we go, "Whew, oh my gosh, that was close." We look at the mirror and say, you know, look at our reflection in the mirror and say, I look like a body, don't I look like a body? I think I'm a body. Spirit, you know, guilt should think I'm a body, right? And so we're looking at the mirror, we're really worried about, like, I wonder if guilt might be able to see through this and recognize I'm not really a body at all. This is just a projection, mental projection. So we're making sure that the body is solid and looks like a body, and you know, we're quite worried about our body image, unless it might reveal the truth, you know. See, this is just standing all of psychology, psychiatry, everything on its head, just completely standing it all on its head here. Maybe it's good I don't have billions of dollars. Otherwise, I'd be running campaign ads and publishing and do all sorts of stuff to give this out to the world. Well, the world wouldn't necessarily like that at all, would it? They say, "Hey, you're blowing our cover, you idiot." It's really something, isn't it? It's not so easy to teach here, is it? Hey, everybody, you know, this is the truth. Shut up, you idiot. Go back to being an idiot. Or, why are you talking to me? I'm an idiot. You know, go talk to someone else. I don't know anything about, I don't understand what you're talking about. Not interested. This is how people react. They're terrified. And you think, "Oh, hey, why don't you just, the truth is so wonderful. What's wrong? Why don't you accept it? What truth? What are you talking about? I don't understand what you're talking about. I think I'll go have another beer." You know. go have a beer and watch TV about a bunch of psychotic killers and stuff, and you think, oh, you know, guilt will never find me here. I look at this idiotic show I'm watching, pretend to be interested in this, and guilt sees that and says, oh, wow, definitely that one is completely dead to spirit, no question about it. This is really something. So when you can play with this, you're going to look at it and say, wow, this is really amazing, the whole perspective. The dreams I've had last night were so profound and so many, and I've seen stuff I never saw before. Oh, this is what's really motivating people. So that's what it's about. You know, this is what I was getting. So all this is arising. Now, I'm able to actually share it, you know, kind of like this in waking sleep. And this deep pretension. That we're just these bodies getting bitten by mosquitoes. Struggling against old age and poverty and all this stuff, and terrified of how we're going to survive, and we say, you know, this is definitely fueling guilt, no question about it. Super clever, artful deceit. And once again, there isn't any guilt at all. There's not one shred of guilt, not even the tiniest bit of guilt. It's never existed, never will. Guilt could only arise if we had done something to God, you know, changed God. But actually, guilt can never arise, because we not only can we not change God, but if we could, we'd be annihilated, and there wouldn't be anything to give rise to guilt. So guilt can never be, from any angle. It's impossible. So I guess we can see now why the awakened ones have so much compassion for everyone. Really, I mean, isn't it just crazy how people are just torturing themselves for no reason whatsoever? I know I've tortured myself hideously, because I was so afraid that guilt would recognize that I was spirit, and then it'd blow not only my cover, but everybody else's. So I said, for the good of everyone, I got to torture myself. So because I had all these indications that I wasn't dead, that I was spirit. So many indications. People say, you're so spiritual. You know, but you got to, you know, we got to educate you. You need to apply yourself to education. In other words, you got to dumb yourself down. What are you doing? And when I get mad at adults, you know, and say, hey, you're just so stupid. Why are you so stupid? Kids get mad at adults, don't they? Because kids say, well, what are you doing? That's stupid. And you just do this. And the adult says, no, gets angry. And the kid's like, what the hell? Why are you shouting angry at me? And she's so frightened. I was just showing you an easy way, the right, you know, simple. No, we don't do it that way. You know, we do it this way. We got to pretend that we're dead here. What are you thinking, crazy kid? You're going to ruin it for everybody. So, and the good kids are the ones, of course, who know how to play dead really well. The parents will say, that's great. The misfits are the ones that aren't so good at it. The society doesn't like them. So we're very clever in how we keep this pretense going, because we throw in all sorts of sort of vestigial echoes of spirit, like we might be interested, but no. Just reinforcing that these are just dying memories. Look, as the corpse is rotting, there's these little memories that are triggered, you know, and how we used to be, and then we, you know, lose interest or fail, and we say, you see, we really are dying. It's dying away. It's dying. We're just a rotting corpse. Well, the spider's back. I just suddenly just, how it zoomed down there. I don't know what it, maybe it's just having fun. You know, just enjoys like swaying in the evening breeze here. Or maybe it's dropped in to listen here. It's like, are you saying, don't blow my cover, man? You're blowing my cover, man. Oh my gosh. All right, so we've done pretty good here. And up you go. Okay, the spider's now going up. Says, look how I'm struggling so badly. You know, gotta work all night on this. What spirit? There's no spirit. What are you talking about? The atheists are, you know, they've got it down good. Like, yeah, what are you talking about? We're just clay. We die. Clay falls apart. That's it. What are you talking about? Don't know anything about that. It's crazy. All you God people are absolutely crazy. Of course, most of the God people are just praying to guilt. That's right. Hey, guilt, I need your help because I'm the corpse of spirit. I'm no longer alive. I'm now dead. And I need your help, guilt, because I can't call on spirit because spirit's dead. I can't do what I used to do. I need your help, guilt, please. Please don't leave me here suffering like this, guilt. What can I do to, you know? This is all designed to convince guilt that you indeed died. Spirit died. So this is all good. It's all very good. And full stop on the wow. Is that another spider? Yeah, there's a bunch of them hanging out. Little tiny ones all over the place. All right. I have an audience here. All right. So just full stop on the wow of this and hear it. And then watch your mind. Watch your mind, how your mind starts pretending like, you know, you're an idiot. I can't even remember. You know, it'll be like, I don't even remember what I said. And I completely forgot it. Well, yeah, the corpse won't be able to remember what's being said, will it? It says, I mean, something seemed to be talking to me, but I don't even remember what it said. And, not really interested in it in any way. I don't even know what it was. So, hey, it was important. I would have remembered, right? So all these defenses keep working, keep working to make us feel like we're absolute clowns, just ridiculously full of stupid clowns. It's all a pretense. It's all a pretense of spirit. We're actually absolutely perfect divine being, pretending that it committed suicide, that it's dead. All right, well, I'm setting myself up for something, aren't I? But I don't want to speculate. Just full, stay in the now. Stay in the full stop of the wow. Full stop of the wow in the now. Not saying yes, not saying no. Just full stop. Neutral. Okay. Go with that neutral mode until all the shock of this wears off. That's quite shocking. Okay. Very great. That's it.